Hey everybody, it's Alma. Welcome back to Keto Meets Menopause. So I put on our Facebook group page. If you're not a member of our Facebook group, check the description below and swing on by. All right, so I put a post out there about gum, guys, and how many carbs, typically about 2.9 carbs per piece of gum. How insane is that? And as many of you guys have found out, some of these gums have 3, 4, 5 different artificial sweeteners and or sugar alcohols in them. On one piece of gum, 5 different types. What is that doing to our insulin? I may find out. So what I did is I went to Sprouts and I purchased a few items that we're gonna give a try. So here's what I'll be doing, all right? I will wake up, I'll test my blood sugar levels. I will then pop in a piece of gum, chew it, and then test in an hour. And we'll see if it affects my blood sugar, all right? So here's what I have, guys, and keep in mind that I will go over the actual ingredients when we get to that particular video. I have this, which is Xylitol mints, all right? I have Spry. I love this gum. This is one of my staples on the trail. So this is pure and the flavor is what? Chocolate mint. I don't know why I love this, but I do love it. They also have other flavors. And I have Xylitol, 2 different flavors. So guys, we're gonna give these a test. These are mostly sweetened with, I believe, xylitol, which I has, if I can remember properly, I think it's a 13 on the glycemic index. So we're gonna see what happens. The way I'm gonna test it is not a full piece of gum, because if I can implement this in my lifestyle for the month of June, I'm probably gonna do a quarter of gum each time. Hi, Daisy. I think that the best way to use your gum, if you have to do it, is to pick and choose. I will be doing it while I'm walking on the trail. It keeps my mouth moist while I'm riding or walking, so I don't have to keep on grabbing my water out of my backpack, and if I'm in a public setting. Other than that, I'm not gonna use it for boredom. I'm not gonna use it just to keep myself busy or just to keep my mouth fresh here at home by myself. So guys, again, pick and choose when you're gonna use it. If you have some gum products that you think I should be testing, let me know. If it's got more than one ingredient, I probably won't be testing it. Okay, all right guys, have a blessed day, bye-bye.
Day one. Testing, it's 5:55 in the morning. Testing out pure gum. All right, let's get started. Day 2, Xylitol, black licorice, good morning. Day 3, testing. Here we go.
Hey everybody, it's Alma. So I just wanted to come in and give you a quick review of my experiment. Guys, if you'll look across those 4 days with the different products that I use, whether it be the Xylitol, by the way, these were purchased at Sprouts, whether it be the Spry Gum, which is also purchased at Sprouts, or the Pure, all of these guys really did not have much of an effect on my numbers. In fact, sometimes it went down, but I think sometimes it was based on the fact that I literally jumped out of bed, tested my blood sugar, and then started moving around. I can't say that it doesn't have an impact, guys, but I would think it's somewhat negligible. And again, if you're using these products, even though they do have xylitol, keep it at a minimum. That doesn't mean chew 12 pieces of gum a day, guys. My goal is to take out one piece of gum, cut it in half, cut it in quarters, whatever, and just use it as I'm needed. And so if you absolutely need it because you're in a public environment, you're in meetings, you're in front of people all the time, use it with discretion, guys. I do think these are some of the better products. This here tasted really good, guys, but it is sweet. It's not gonna achieve the desire of freshening your breath. Out of all of these, my two favorite are the Purr. This would be my absolute favorite. Again, this one is their chocolate mint, but they do have about four or five different flavors. And here are the ingredients. It's xylitol based. Xylitol did have a 13 on the glycemic index scale. While there are other ingredients that are somewhat questionable, guys, my focus for this is strictly the sugar alcohols and the artificial sweeteners. So this one here is 5 calories. It is 0 net carbs with the xylitol. And again, it did not seem to have an effect on me. However, you never know, you never know, you never know. Now, here's the danger point, guys, is we're all looking to find things to make our life keto adapted, a keto fix, a keto, anything to make our keto life more pleasurable and more similar to the way we lived when most of us were following a standard American diet, Weight Watchers, whatever it might be. You look at the majority of these and yeah, that's a beautiful word, sugar-free, but what they don't tell you is it still has your artificial sweeteners and or sugar alcohols that may not be the best choice for you. Look at this, guys. Oh, my friend turned me on to this. And it was great, sugar-free, great, great, great to have. Look, sugar-free, 120 pieces, very inexpensive. You take these on the, put two or three of these in my backpack and I'm ready to go for a 3-hour walk on the trail and not have to get worried about passing out because my mouth was so dry. Yes, I take water, guys, but still. So look at that, hey, 2 calories, 2 grams of carbs, sugar alcohols too, 0 net carbs. Okay, yeah, if you say so. But if you look at the ingredients, xylitol gum base, and you look at the mannitol, then you look at the citric acid, you look at the aspartame, you look at the, yeah, look at it. Says it all, guys. So these are the things that we want to go ahead and take out of our life when possible. Okay, so this is the stuff that we just need to say. No. Oh, yeah. How about this? Dollar Tree. No. Look at that. Sorbitol, maltitol, xylitol, aspartame. Nope. Going to the healthier items, guys. All the technical data on the blood testing may not have been extremely informative. You know, guys, it's at least trying to be more aware of what I am doing in my ketogenic journey. I hope you guys continue to educate yourself as I am doing every day. And if you're on a keto channel, you're educating yourself, guys. Take what you can, leave the rest, be friendly, engage with others, and have a blessed day, guys. I look forward to seeing you soon. Bye-bye. And don't forget, guys, we start June 1st on our June challenge to rid ourselves of the majority of sugar alcohols and artificial sweeteners. And let me tell you, everyone's welcome. If you're saying, look, I'm gonna give up everything except for the aspartame, Alma, that's fine. If you're saying, I'm gonna give up everything but the sorbitol, that's fine. As long as you're trying to better yourself during that month by reducing. And hey, if you're saying, Alma, I'm giving it all up, even better. I would love to see your results. Thank you so much for allowing me to spend time with you. If you haven't already done so, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit that notification button so that you'll know each time I post a new video. All right, guys, have a great day. Bye-bye.
Joyce Wednesday, it's so neato. Now here's my wife to teach us keto. Pork rinds, rah, rah, rah. Carbohydrates, blah, blah, blah.